but give a very warm welcome to Dr. Collins.
Neuralcentrism, a new term for an old concept, a proposal for the introduction and assimilation of this novel term into the chiropractic lexicon. Coulter wrote, where was I going to get stuff? I just went into the Western States Library and I started looking about some things that I felt would bolster what I was trying to express. And he said, look, it's really important as a profession that we've got to, and I missed last night because last night I heard was really exciting. He says, we've got to clarify, our concepts. And from what I've seen, I'm not an expert on the literature, but I've seen the public perception of chiropractic isn't so much as negative as it's a mixed bag of confusion about what it is we do and what we are trying to do. And it's because they're getting different signals from different aspects of the, 70,000 chiropractors in the United States, and I don't know how many worldwide. But he said it's of paramount importance if we are to expand our cultural authority. So I'm proposing that a new highly precise term is needed that clearly describes chiropractic's unique paradigm. And by the way, I love him. I just love you, Chris. And you and Pat, through just my exposure to you guys through On Purpose and other places like that, have really, helped me a lot about trying to clarify, where you have to define terms. And that's one of the things that I learned in studying some of the, great chiropractors of today. You have to define yourself before you can have a conversation. And it's really interesting how chiropractic itself really is about, I think, communication occurring more clearly and concisely. And sometimes we don't communicate with ourselves as a culture. So that's part of the reason why I'm the moderator of this giant listserv, of this big listserv, is because I really wanted to increase communication in the state of Oregon for the betterment of the patients and of our profession. So, I could have taken I think it's the 28th principle from Stevenson and probably put it in there. I made one that I was using. Anyway, to acknowledge the primacy of the nervous system and to therefore focus special attention on its structure and function. That's certainly what you were talking about. We're focusing special attention on its structure and function. So, neural meaning of or pertaining to the nervous system, and centrism meaning, assigning some degree of primacy and focusing on that. This is where I'm completely, out of my element. I'm in Sherman, and I'm not going to talk to you guys about the history of chiropractic. But obviously, I do remember enough, I did know enough that there was a differentiation. It was one of the things that differentiated chiropractic from other forms of body work or manipulation or physical types of mobilization and manipulation, osteopathy being one of them. And here we go on the ACC paradigm. It's just called the principle. It's the only principle in the ACC paradigm. The body's innate recuperative power is affected by and integrated through the nervous system. Well, to me, that is another definition of neurocentrism. If you make that statement based on your observation of reality and the basic sciences, and you believe that, then that's a neurocentric metaphysical paradigm. Is it not? I think it is. So, in fact, straight chiropractic is founded upon, or at least in part, on neuralcentrism. Neuralcentrism, and the discussion continued here, Coulter again. And I didn't know about this paper when I was trying to create my values. But it's really interesting how we got three of them in common. And so he studied the history to a degree, I guess, and he came up with the concepts that chiropractic was actually, a conglomeration of pre-existing philosophies, is what he said in this paper, vitalism, holism, therapeutic conservatism, naturalism, critical rationalism. So vitalism, although commonly used to describe chiropractic, I think it's insufficient in some ways. There are other definitions of it, but I just looked it up online. You know, a doctrine that processes of life are not explicable by the laws of physics and chemistry alone, and that life is in some part self-determined. So what does that have to do? How do we get to adjusting spine-correcting subluxations from there without having to go through a three-year, you know, I don't want to go through the diplomate right here yet. But it's hard for just a person on the street to make that leap, perhaps, if we're trying to describe what it is we do and how we get to that of the most common, you know, thing that we do. So I think one of the ways to help the general public and chiropractors within the profession make that leap is by using this term. As defined above, it's a cornerstone of chiropractic thinking and clinical practice. I believe it's neuralcentrism that sets chiropractic apart from other healers / health professionals who claim to embrace vitalism, holism, etc. Something else about Oregon that's interesting is that there's more naturopaths there per capita than any other state. And it's a lot of naturopaths. And the school, the naturopathic college, is bigger than the chiropractic college. And they're smart. They have money when they go in there, and they're well educated, and they're coming out and they're practicing, and they collaborate, and, you know, wow, they're really on a roll. I can tell you that. They are, for sure. There's about 300 of them. And guess what? They say they're vitalistic. They say they're naturalistic. They say they're holistic. They say they're conservative. You know, so, wow, you know, hey, where does that put the chiropractor? So there's also a school there, the only physical therapy school in Oregon is, their only degree now is a doctor of physical therapy. That's the only degree they provide. And you're just going to see DPTs everywhere because you can get your degree online. You know, you can get a DPT on the internet. So if you have your master's in physical therapy. So this is a big argument. And this is where I'm out of the mainstream in Oregon. A lot of the chiropractors in Oregon just want to, you know, beat them down by saying they can't do adjustments or they can't do manipulations or they can't do high velocity, low amplitude procedures. And they don't, the chiropractors right now in our leadership aren't clearly defining what it is that they don't want them to do. Thank you, I think those are questions. So again, what I'm saying is, you know, the only way we can differentiate ourselves from doctors in physical therapy is by our intention. What's our intention? What's our purpose? That's the way we've got to differentiate ourselves. And that's what I've been trumpeting for the last 5 years in Oregon, is that what makes us unique is our intention, it's our purpose. And of course that's based upon our philosophy, our viewpoint of how the world works. And that's why I think this term can be helpful, because you could have two people lay somebody down on a table, someone twist someone's back or something like that, someone else do something that looks similar, but one person is giving a chiropractic adjustment and the other one's doing a spinal manipulation. And they're different. They're different through their intention. The adjustment is more neurocentric and the manipulation is mechanistic or mechanical. So, anyway, I just felt like this was a way to, put it in our heads that we are different. Sherman is a more neural-centric chiropractic college. Western States is not very neural-centric. See, there's all kinds of ways to use it within our profession to differentiate. Then there are ways to use it outside of the profession, to the patient, to legislators, to the medical profession, physical therapy profession, etc. I hope that we do eventually integrate this word into our profession, because I do believe it would be helpful. Well, I thank you folks. I appreciate the opportunity.